In the name of the Father,
In
of
the
the
name
Son,
of
of the
the
Holy
Jesus Christ,
Spirit.
the Holy
Amen.
Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. Come, Holy Spirit, fill the hearts of your faithful and enkindle in them the fire of your love. Send forth your Spirit and they shall be created, and you shall renew the face of the earth. O God, who by the light of the Holy Spirit instructs the hearts of the faithful, grant us with the same Holy Spirit to be truly wise and always to rejoice in His consolation through Christ our Lord. Amen.
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 Amen. From the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
At that time, Jesus exclaimed, "I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Pitali. You hear me?
Yes, yes.
Can you hear me well?
Yes, loud and clear.
Please go ahead, Tita Lynn.
The three pointers for today's gospel. Number one, we can read books about God and be engaged passionately in philosophical discussions about truth and eternal laws of the world and human living. All these are unimportant if we do not really love God. Number two, however, to know God personally is infinitely more important. This is the divine gift to know Him in our heart and experience Him as intimately present to all that happened to us in our daily living. Number three, pray that our hearts are receptive to the gift of His love and are able to sense His affection within us so that we can live and do His will more fully. Amen.
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 Thank you very much, Tita Lynn. In one of the homilies that I have watched and I have listened to, no, yesterday's gospel is about Jesus, no, saying, "Woe to you, Bethsaida, Capernaum," because no matter how much he did a lot of miracles in those towns, but the people didn't listen. And then, ito ngayon is he is praising, he is thanking God the Father for the revelation to the childlike. So parang hope ba, hope sa atin. So in contrast to yesterday's gospel and today's gospel, yesterday's gospel, no, ang mga tao doon is non-believer, because of pride, mostly because of pride. Tapos ito ngayon is childlike. Jesus revealed to the Father the childlike faith of these people, no? So the revelation of God sa childlike, no? Who are the childlike? The humble of hearts, like a child, all trusting, very dependent on the Lord. Yun. And he prayed to the Father. He prayed to God the Father, to this people who are childlike, with childlike attitude. So what happened to these people na arrogant, no? What happened to them? Because of their intellectual pride. They are, for them, no, they are so learned, they are so educated that they depend on themselves. They all depend on themselves because they thought, no? They thought na okay sila, they are so learned, so nabaliwala na ang God. Because they thought na everything revolved in them, and everything, all the success, all those achievements, no, because of them, not because of God. It is very, very true sa modern time natin, no, may mga tao na ganyan, no, because of their fame, because of their money, because of their skills, because of their talent, they forgot that these are all blessings. So they thought na kaya ko, because of me, because parang me ito, because of me I became like this, because of me, because I'm hardworking, I became like this. No, you have to recognize that all of these are all blessings lahat. Oh. and then child, everything coming from him. So itong childlike naman attitude, no, ito ang the best attitude. Ito ang gustong-gusto ni God sa atin. Be dependent on Him. Be like a child. Very dependent. Ang faith and all trusting. Dapat ganyan tayo. When we face any problems, trials in life, we let us all pray and trust everything to Him. That's why yung magandang prayer during face of trials, no, and sufferings and pains, like Lord, I entrust to you everything. Thy will be done, O Lord. I entrust to you everything. Yun ang all trusting and faith, childlike. Yun ang gusto ni Lord sa atin. No pretense, no pride, nothing. Just be humble. Just be humble and the knowledge that we are nothing. We are nothing without God. We are nothing. Yes. Amen.
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 Funny first.
Okay. Kalbo first.
According to beauty, dito mans, ikaw una.
Ikaw muna.
Reflection, no, by Marino. It says, what is the key to know God's will for you? It's humility. A humble person is ever ready to listen to the voice and the will of God. He, she doesn't go against the will of God, and he, she rather allows God's will to work in his or her life. In the process of allowing God's will to rule his or her life, he or she discovers more about God. Yeah. Because usually a learned, something that it's a gospel, a learned person, wise person, sometimes think that they don't need God at all. Because they are so proud of being knowing all. When you are humble, you open yourself to countless blessings that emanate from God. You may ask, how am I going to be humble in the front of God? You have to follow the rules of Jesus and of the church, which Jesus founded through Saint Peter. For example, the teaching of the Sunday Holy Mass obligation, a humble person would always see to it that he or she is always present in this sacred celebration. Another example is our humble submission to the sacraments, most especially the sacrament of reconciliation. Yeah, a humble person would always find time to confess his or her sins to a priest who acts in the person of Jesus Christ. Yeah, it takes humility to kneel down, the confessional, to confess your sin. It takes not only courage, but humility. Jesus always looks kindly to those who are childlike and humble. Why? Because this is the nature of God. He loves those who are humble, and he reveals himself more to the childlike and the humble. Do you want to know more about God? And do you want to have a deeper friendship with the Lord? Kagaya nga sinabi ni Tita MJ, you know, the people of yesterday's gospel, and the people of Chorazin and ano po yan?
Bethsaida, Capernaum.
They are learned, or I don't know, and they don't recognize or listen to the teachings of Jesus anymore. But in the gospel of today, Jesus is thankful to the Father. I praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth. For although you have hidden the things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to the childlike. So only the childlike probably will know what the Lord wants to impart to them. See? Because they're willing to listen. But those people in that area, in Chorazin and Bethsaida, they're probably deaf. No? They don't want to listen. They refuse to listen. And here in the gospel now, Jesus is thankful because at least his people, humble, the childlike, listen to his teachings. And only the humble will be receptive to this, to Jesus' teachings. Because if you are proud, you know, a proud person will not listen to anybody anymore, knowing that he knows everything already. Yun ang problema. Sobrang dunong ng tao, parang dinodyos na yung sarili niya. And it says here, if you want to have a deeper relationship with the Lord, you need to humble yourself, to be childlike. Okay. Amen to that. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you very much, Tito. So, be humble, be like a child, childlike. Childlike means very dependent to God. And faith is really deep and all trusting. Trust the Lord. So, do you have something, Tita Belle?
The 3 points of Father Tito are almost the same as Marino das Marinia. So, number one is the wisdom of grace, because the opening of the gospel is you have kept this hidden from the wise and the learned. And the wisdom hidden from the wise and the learned is because they are not humble. They think so highly of themselves. They think that they're the only ones who are so knowledgeable. And they don't consider that all these gifts are from God himself. So this is not actually, the statement of Jesus is not really an anti-intellectual nor irrational. It's a non-rational intelligence. I don't know how many types of intelligence now that has been discovered, but this line meant the spiritual intelligence, the realm of the spiritual, more of spiritual intelligence, which harps on the beauty of nature to rejoice in the mercy of God and good works, meaning we encounter the Lord in solitude and in silence. And the second point is, he has revealed to the childlike. That's what you just discussed, MJ and Tito Manny, regarding the qualities of a child, that they are trusting and they are open to things and they are exploratory, no? Sabi ni Father Tito, the famous line of ababaw ang kaligayahan. Children can easily rejoice in simple things in life. No?
That is true.
Because they're so easy to please, easy to let enjoy things presented to them. Can easily rejoice in simple things in life. And really, really be joyful in the surprises of grace. Diba? We easily say, praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord, in the small things that happen to our lives, in the daily happiness, even no matter how small. We always say, praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord. That's the one of the characteristics of a child. So humble, so simple, so trusting, and enjoys life so easily, no? The simple things. So on the third point is the relationship between God the Father and God the Son, no? In the closing statement of our Gospel of the day, no one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. So it's the relationship of God. Our relationship with God is really through Christ. And what the Father wants us to know, he reveals it through the Son, through Jesus. So that's how we develop our relationship. Amen.
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 Amen. So very true. Going back to this, the learned, the self-sufficient, self-sufficient people, no? Marami tayo na sa modern life natin na marami tayong nalaman na atheist. Mga very, very successful people, pero mga atheist sila. Bill Gates, atheist. Elon Musk himself is atheist. Si, dami pa, si Warren Buffett. Mga billionaire yan, ha? They have all these riches and skills and talents, no? And hard work, no? Na they are so blessed with so many money, but they are atheists. They don't believe in God, na all these things are blessings from God. No, sa kanila is because of me, because of myself, because I'm hardworking, because of this, because of that, maganyan ba? So baliwala na ang God sa kanila. So bottom line here, no, is we always pray, we always ask ourselves, no, who is Jesus in our life, di ba? So baliktari natin. Do you think if Jesus looks at us, looks at our heart, do you think that Jesus will pray to God the Father or to praise Him because of our hearts? Yun, baliktari natin. Kung si Jesus, kaya no, tingnan ang puso natin. When Jesus is looking at our hearts, Is he going to pray and praise God the Father because of our hearts, what is inside our hearts? Yun. Are we humble enough? Do we have enough faith? Are we prayerful enough? Now, when Jesus looks at our hearts, we have, oh, praise God, God our Father. Praise this faithful heart. So, be honest, no? Be honest tayo, no? Lord Jesus, look at our hearts now. Are you looking at our hearts? Are you going to pray and praise God the Father because of our hearts? Yun. As simple as that. Mm-hmm. Will Jesus say that, na, oh, you have childlike faith. You have childlike humility. So praise God the Father. We will try our best, no? Now, when Jesus will look at our hearts, no? He will sing praises to God the Father. So, amen.
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 Amen. Amen.
So, any other comments or thought? Piece of your thought?
Hello, June.
Ha.
May paragraph lang akong, you already said it, pero sige, basahin ko to. Brothers and sisters, there is the spirit of arrogance that so easily grows in us when we become proud of our human wisdom and intelligence. So sinabi mo na ito, June, sinabi Bill Gates and everyone. The wiser we become in our own eyes, the more foolish we become in God's eyes, because we become blind to the very things that He wants so much to reveal to us. It is not the most learned who are the spiritually wisest, but the most childlike. As we can see from the many examples of clever people in the world who are spiritually quite foolish. So, yun, sinabi mo na to, June, kanina. Yeah? And then, meron pa dito, ha? Without revelation, we could not know about Jesus' relationship with the Father or their life in union with the Holy Spirit. We could not know about the presence of Jesus in the Eucharist or recognize that the church is His body and earth. By faith, we join Jesus in offering grateful praise to the Father, the only one who fully knows the Father, for He reveals the Father to us so that we too can know Him and love Him. Amen.
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 Amen. Thank you, Nix. Yeah, beautiful. So, yun, the learned. Mga learned, successful na mga tao. Sadly, no, a lot of them don't recognize God, that all these blessings come from God. They became, they are atheists. They are atheists. So sad, no?
Because they just consider their success that they were the ones who made their lives, not God. Oh,
not God.
Oh. They didn't realize that the hands of God really work on them because they just believe in themselves. So that's the reason why Jesus chose His disciples, His first apostles, from fishermen, because they are childlike. They are so humble.
Very humble.
So Jesus did not choose those who are in the elite group, but rather in
the humble,
among the fishermen, the humble
fishermen,
people.
Not even educated. May isang may nag-comment na one of the homilies na we don't even know if they can read and write well, itong mga apostles, ang mga first apostles ba?
But they're the ones chosen by Jesus.
Yeah, but they were chosen. Amen.
The chosen.
The chosen. Tayo ang mga chosen. Modern life. Modern life, oh. No? Tayo ang chosen, ba ya? Yeah.
Jonathan Romy.
Yeah, so anyway, thank you very much. And I think that's it for today's gospel and reflection. No? Beautiful message, once again. Very beautiful message. And then let's just make sure now when Jesus looks at us, what will Jesus say about us? Is he going to pray and praise God the Father because of our faith? Tingnan natin. Okay, when Jesus looks at Tita Bell, oh, Tita Bell, wow, this is you. Praise God the Father for Tita Bell.
I was struck by your statement, MJ, because when I go to Mass at Redemptorist, I usually sit on the left side, and right in front of me is the Sacred Heart of Jesus, and that's my prayer. Dear Jesus, I bear my heart to you. Look at my heart, my sinful heart, as if you are really looking at the eyes of Jesus and begging him to forgive you for your sinful self in spite of his goodness and his love and his mercy and compassion. You still continue to sin and sin all over, even if you go to confession once a month, every 2 weeks. Then you commit the same sins over and over again. That's why I said, maybe Jesus, you will tell me, I'll kick you down there.
Instead of praying to God the Father. Napaka-humble mo naman. You're so humble. Pero
natawa ako sa statement mo kasi na-remember ko yung prayer ko na I bear my heart to you. O Sacred Heart of Jesus.
No matter how impure.
Sabi ni Father Santos, kasi I once told him na, you know, Father, because of my sins, I go to confession every 2 weeks. Sabi ni Ding, ano ka ba? Bakit ka punta-punta ng confession every 2 weeks? Sabi ni Father, oh, grabe ka naman, Dok, Tita Dok. Hindi yun, hindi every 2 weeks ang confession. Once a month lang. Once a month lang daw.
Ay, ibang
every 2 weeks.
Ay, ibang pare nga, sabi na, you are, ano, we are always confessing your sin and then it's still the same.
The same. All over again.
All over again.
Not cool.
Yeah, so.
Sisipain na tayo ni Jesus.
So that's today's message, no? Make sure that our heart is clean and pure, because so that magpray naman si Jesus when looking at us, in our hearts, no? Magsabi naman siya, oh, praise God the Father. hindi na sa Tita Bell, sisipain
kita dyan.
But you know, pray the Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Yeah, no?
Make yung, my heart like
nine
your
hours.
Heart.
9 hours, novena. So nice.
Or if not, yung regular na pray daily ba? Na Sacred Heart of Jesus, make my heart like your heart.
Like unto thine.
Meek and humble. Amen.
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 Tita Flor, for the closing prayer, thank you very much. That was very, very good.
Our closing prayer. Dear Lord, as we end our prayer meeting tonight, nothing is impossible for you, and we are humbled by the fact that you are present to help us to conquer its moment. In Jesus' name,
Amen.
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 And all together, please, glory be to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you all. Thank you very much. Love you guys.
Bye.